Hi, I'm Ram Kumar. I run this place called Our Native Village. We started this in 2006. It's what I call a 100% eco resort because from an energy, water, waste management, architecture and the food chain perspective, we use sustainable technologies for our resort. We started this in 2006 because I have a deep interest in sustainability. I don't have any experience running a hotel, or I'm not even qualified to run, or I've never owned a hotel before. But I'm very passionate about sustainability, and this is a huge experiment in sustainability. So I always tell my guests, you know, welcome to this experiment called Our Native Village. We are trying to see, is it possible for man to live a sustainable life in the modern era? Not a Gandhian lifestyle where you slept on the floor and drank goat's milk and ate peanuts, but in a modern context, with all the creature comforts, is it possible? And we've proven that with our resort. Those are the sort of origins of why we started the resort. And of course, after I started it, I told myself, are people going to come here because I'm an eco resort? And the answer was no. So we went on a revivalist path to deliver experiences which people will value. And those experiences relate to the Indian village. That's why I call it an Our Native Village, because my best memories of my childhood was going back to my native village. So in a village, you have experiences which are precious for the urbanite today. Rituals, games, practices from the Indian village are all slowly dying, and the urbanites have not been exposed to it at all. A lot of our children, don't you know what a gilli danda is? So in terms of experiences, we are delivering those experiences. So you come here, you learn how to go on a bullock cart, you get what we call a bullock cart driving license. Now we acclaim to be the only place in the world that issues you a bullock cart driving license. It's just fun stuff, right? Yeah. So you go on a bullock cart, you learn how to milk a cow, you learn how to farm, you play a lot of village games like gilli danda and flying kites and spinning tops. And I always say, ever since, you know, the advent of Formula One racing, we have our own version of Formula One racing. It's called cycle tire racing. You know, it's fun stuff. And then we teach people how to do pottery, how to do rangoli, how to make a flower garland. Stuff that, in my opinion, is very precious today in terms of experience, because it's not available in the urban space. So in a way, what we have to offer here really at a core is simplicity. It's a simple life, because we all have gone so far down the path of leading a very complex life. Is a joy of simple living, is a joy of simplicity, and to go back with this realization that you can lead a perfectly healthy, happy, joyous and beautiful life in a simple manner too. That is what we are doing here.
And any activities outside the property that they can partake in when they are here?
Yes, of course, there's a lot happening in this entire area, which is Hesargatta, which is North Bangalore. There is Nrityagram, which is Pratima Bedi's dance school, where you can go there and watch the dancers practice. There is an old 4th century historic site called Ivarkandapura, where the Pandavas are supposed to have been there, you know, during the Vanavas. That is available. And then at a little outer ring, there is Nandi Hills, which is not too far off. There is a Kukke Subramanya temple site, which is not far off. And there's the Shravana Belugola, which is a Jain site, you know, a Jain religious site. Which has a large monolithic Buddha, that is also not far off. So, and then we have the open grasslands, which we are very proud of, very close to us, which is a wintering ground for migratory birds of prey. It's the last remaining open grasslands of Bangalore. So that is also available. And most importantly, it is just the sense of space and openness. A lot of times when people ask me, you know, are you a 4-star resort? Are you a 5-star resort? I always tell people this, you know, I have no clue whether I'm 4-star, 5-star or 3-star. But one thing I can promise you, every night I promise to show you a million stars. And that kind of living is what I call sort of 7-star, 8-star living. That much I can promise.